Many of you would be aware that if you have a file in your Google Drive, so say this one for example, so here's a file, it's a table of information, and I'd like to send this to other people in the school. And you probably realize that I can click the share button up here, and I can add names in here and choose who to share it to, and they'll get a notification and they'll be able to go into their Google Drive and check it out. So that's something that I think some of you are very well aware of. But what I'm not sure you realize is you can also distribute this any file in your Google Drive to other people via email as though it was an attachment. Now I say attachment in inverted quotes here because it's not really an attachment in that it doesn't get attached to the email and it doesn't then get distributed to multiple people. Let me show you what I mean. If I go into my Google Drive and I compose a new message and I'll send this to say I always send things to Chris Waterman, so there you go, and take a look. And I'd like to now say, here is that file you wanted. Okay, now I'd like to attach the file. And the file's in my Google Drive, so it's not really a file in the traditional sense. So if I go down over this paperclip here, you'll see a little flyout menu comes out the side. And the second option there is insert files using Drive. So if I click on that, I can then go into my file browser here and go into my Drive and find the file I'm after, and it's this one here. So I just tick that, and if I wanted to tick multiple files, I could also go down and sort of tick other things as well. I'll just do one in this case, but you could attach several, and then you simply click the insert button, and what you get then is this file attached, and again in quote marks, into the email as though it was an attachment. Now when I send that, this file's not actually shared with Chris at the moment, so if I send that, it will pop up a little box and say, this Drive file isn't shared with the recipient. Would you like to share it with him? Now, you have a couple of options. You can just say anyone who gets this can view it, and that's the default, and it's probably the most sensible option. But if it was a sensitive document, and you specifically only wanted one person to be able to see it, you can go to more options, and you can only the recipients of this email can view. And of course, if you wanted, you can change to edit or can comment as well. But normally, you go can view. Now, when you do that, if I just change it to that, the sharing settings on that document were just set to view only to Chris Waterman, and so he'll get that email. And if I go back into the document, where was it called, this one here, and I take a look at the sharing settings, you'll see that it actually added that recipient in as a viewer only. Now, I've actually gone through the process of sharing that document, but I've done it in a way that a lot of people feel far more comfortable with, and that is by composing an email, going down here and attaching, in quote marks, a file from their Drive. A couple of advantages of doing it this way is there is only ever one copy of the file, so it's always the most recent, most up-to-date version. You're not distributing hundreds of copies of a file out to hundreds of email boxes. You're simply sending an email with a link back to a single copy of that document, a master copy if you like. So it's always a single source of truth. The other advantage is when you attach a file to an email, there's a size limit. I think it's currently 7 megabytes is the largest you can attach to an email. When you do it this way, if you store it in your Drive and simply link to it as an attachment, you can actually store up to 10 gigabytes, so it's considerably more. So I hope that makes sense, and I hope you guys find some interesting uses for being able to send files around the school, but you do them as Drive files, but send them as attachments.